Hello, good morning my dear students. Welcome back to your English class. Students, I am Santosh Rathore and I am going to take English for this session. Students, hope you all are fit and fine at home. We all know that just because of COVID-19 pandemic, we will not be able to reopen the school. So, our school has decided to start the online classes. So, students, you all have to take the advantage of this opportunity and you must be regular in your study. You have to watch the video lessons regularly, and in the next week we will be starting Zoom classes as well. So you have to attend all of them as well. Now students, we will be giving homework to you as well. Okay, so you have to do your homework regularly and you have to send the homework to the particular or relevant teacher between 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Okay students, so I hope all the things are clear to you. Now students, we are going to start a topic of English grammar, that is parts of speech, right students? So what is parts of speech? Student, parts of speech is the basic unit of English grammar. Okay, if you will learn parts of speech, then only you will be able to speak English correctly or write English correctly. So the parts of speech explain how a word is used in a sentence, right? How any word is used in a sentence is told by the parts of speech only, right? So how many kinds of parts, how many parts of speech are there? There are 8 parts of speech, right? So we will learn about them. So first is noun, second is pronoun, third adjective, fourth adverb, and then verb, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. Students, you all know about all these topics. So let's read the definition of noun. Noun is a word used as a name of a person, place, thing, or any idea or feeling, right? So you can say that noun is a naming word, right? So a noun is a naming word. You all know, because you all are learning the definition of noun since you know very junior classes, right? So you can see the examples here in this sentence. Ram is a noun and Delhi is a name of place, so Delhi is a noun. Cat is a noun, name of animal, and table is the name of thing, so it is also a noun, right? Student, we will read about the kinds of noun and you know about all these things deeply when we will start the chapter. Okay, we are having a just a glance on the parts of speech today. Okay, so we will read about it deeply later on, don't worry. So these are the kinds of noun, you know, proper noun, common noun, collective noun, and abstract noun, right? Now the next part of speech is pronoun. So what are pronoun? A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. What does instead of a noun means? Instead of a noun means in place of noun, right? In place of a noun. So to avoid the repetition of noun or pronoun, we use noun means to avoid the repetition of noun, we use pronoun, right? So you can see the examples here. He, she, it, they, them, and many more, right? Next is, these are the kinds of pronoun. We will read about it deeply later on. These are adjectives. Now what are adjectives? You all know that adjectives are words that are used to describe noun and pronoun and to qualify, quantify, and identify them, right? So you know, if you are describing any noun or pronoun, then you will describe them with some words, and that word, all those words will be called adjective. So you can have a look at this example. He was wearing a black shirt. So you can see that what is noun in this sentence. Can you identify? Students, in this sentence, shirt is a noun. And the word which is describing this noun is black. Okay, so black is adjective because this word is describing how the noun is or how the noun was. Clear? So next is kinds of adjective. So these are the kinds of adjective. We'll read later on deeply. Now, what is adverb? Students, an adverb is a word that can modify a verb, an adjective or another adverb. Lots of adverbs and with ly. Right. Now, the basic difference between noun and adjective, you know, that an adjective describes noun or pronoun, whereas an adverb describes verb or adjective or another adverb. Right. So you can see the example, she swims quickly. Okay, so swims is a verb. Okay, you know what is verb? Verb is an action word, right? So swims is a verb here, and quickly is describing this verb, and that's the reason quickly will be called adverb, right? So we can say that adverb describe verb. Now these are the kinds of adverb. Now what is verb? You all know very well that what is verb, right, students? So what is verb? Verbs are doing or action words because they describe what the subject, means noun or pronoun of a sentence, is doing, right? So these are the example of verb: cook, sing, walk, talk. Okay, so you can see more examples. A boy is running, means a boy is a noun, right? And running is a verb. Clear? So verb, cooking is a verb, studying is a verb, means these all are the actions which are done by the noun or pronoun. So these are the action word, and you can say that these are verbs. Okay, now let's move forward and understand the next topic, that is preposition. So now students, what is preposition? Okay, a preposition is a word or set of words that indicates the location. Okay, so location is told by the preposition, with the words called prepositions. Okay, in, near, beside, on top of, etc. Right, so to understand it more clearly, let's have a look on the these pictures. You can see that there is a ball and a box on each side. So you can say that this ball is in the box, on the box, under the box, next to the box, right? So these all are the preposition. It means prepositions indicate the location of any object or a person. Now conjunction, you know that what are the conjunctions? Student, conjunctions are the linking words. They connect two phrases, two sentences, two clauses or two words together. And why we use conjunctions? Student, we use conjunctions to make our sentences shorter, sweeter and simpler, meaningful. Okay, so there are three kinds of conjunctions. So they are coordinating conjunction, subordinating conjunctions and correlative conjunctions. So we will have a look on all these conjunctions deeply when once we start the chapter. So this is last kind of, you know, part of speech. So what is interjection? An interjection is a word or phrase that expresses emotion. Okay, emotion can be any kind. I have any kind. So hooray, wow, hooray, etc. So you know, interjection shows the emotion. So it can be surprising, shocking, right? So one more important thing is that an interjection is usually punctuated with an exclamation point. Now, do you know, students, what is exclamation point or exclamation sign? So this is an exclamatory sign. So along with all the interjection, you have to add interjection, it means exclamation point. Okay, so this was interjection. You can see these images and clear it more Now students, I hope you have got my point, and this is all for today's class. Students, what you have to do for your homework is you all have to watch this video very carefully, and you have to learn the definition of each part of speech and try to understand them. Clear? So this is all for today's class. Hope you have enjoyed the class and understood it well. And if you find any kind of doubt, you can ask me, and you can call me or you can message me on my WhatsApp number. Thank you for watching.